الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, alhamdulillah. We just finished the Salat al-Fajr in Jama'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it an awr hasanat. Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. Let's talk today, inshallah, about the importance of being hamdan lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of those who are praising Allah, saying alhamdulillah. And alhamdulillah, kalima, it's a word in Arabic, tufid al-alif wal-lam in the beginning of the word, tufid al-istighraq. Al-istighraq means all praises and thanks are due to Allah Azza wa Jal. Alhamd, kull alhamd, all alhamd. That's why this word is very important in Islam. I will give you some dalils from the Quran, the Sunnah, about the importance of saying alhamdulillah, to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah An-Naml, verse 59, قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, say الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. And he said in Surah Al-Isra, وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ, say الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Surah An-Naml said, قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, قُلْ مِنْ, say الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, praise Allah. وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى عِبَادِهِ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَى, salam, peace upon the anbiya of Allah, those who've been chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah khayrun amma yushrikun. Allah is asking you. Wa qala ta'ala, Surah An-Naml, verse 93. Wa qul alhamdulillah, last ayah, last verse. And say alhamdulillah again. Huh? Praise Allah. Say alhamdulillah. Sayurikum ayatihi fata'rifunaha. He will show you his signs, proofs, evidences of his existence. And you will recognize it. فَتَعْرِفُونَهَا. And these ayat until the day of judgment. فَتَعْرِفُونَهَا. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah is not heedless about what you, he's aware, he's accounted, he's aware about what you are doing. That's why don't be one of those who are jahideen and grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal. You have to be grateful to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And you have to recognize Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala ni'am, favors, bounties upon you. And alhamdulillah, thana alallah. Thana alallah means, يعني سبحان الله, Allah loves that. When you say alhamdulillah, when تثني على الله بأسمائه. Thana alallah means to declare it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfect, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is not similar to us, Azza wa Jal. That's why when you say alhamdulillah or subhanallah, بتنزه الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وتثني على الله. فالله سبحانه وتعالى loves that. And also الله سبحانه وتعالى مدح نفسه وبكل أوصاف الكمال والأفضال. Is perfect سبحانه وتعالى الكمال والجلال. الله عز وجل said ضرب الله مثلا عبدا مملوكا لا يقدر على شيء ومن رزقناه منا رزقا حسنا فهو ينفق منه سرا وجهرا هل يستوون الحمد لله. See this ayah or these two words been repeated in the Quran too many times. Alhamdulillah. Who said Alhamdulillah? Allah is talking about himself. He's praising himself. Alhamdulillah. بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون. Subhanallah. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising himself? Because me and you cannot do it. Whatever kind of ibadah we are doing, we cannot really, subhanallah, praise Allah the way Allah wants. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he praises himself subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have Surah Al-Fatiha, one of its names, Imam Abu Bakr al-Jazair, rahimahullah, in his book, Minhaj al-Muslim, he mentioned 11 names for Surah Al-Baqarah. One of its names, Surah Al-Hamd. Surah Al-Hamd. That's why min al-Sunnah for the Imam to recite al-Basmala secretly, according to the what Rasulullah did and the Sahaba, Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. And also Aisha and Mu'tar al-Ansariya, too many of the Sahabiyat, they declared that Rasulullah SAW, when he used to lead the Salah, كان يسر بالبسملة ويبدأ بالحمد. He used to recite البسملة, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, said his heart, and he used to start what? بالحمد. That's why it says Surah Al-Hamd, Surah Al-Fatiha, one of its names. Alhamdulillahi, Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started some of the surah of the Quran with Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. He praised himself. Like, Alhamdulillah الذي خلق السماوات والأرض. Alhamdulillah, all praises are due to Allah, the one who created the seven heavens and seven earth. وَجَعَلَ الظُّلُمَاتِ وَالنُّورِ And he created the nights and the light. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ يَعْدِلُونَ He's the only creator and the kuffar. They are creating fake gods and they said they are equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the beginning of Surah Al-An'am. Also Allah said in Surah Al-Kahf, Alhamdulillah الذي أنزل على عبده الكتابة ولم يجعل له عوجا. Subhanallah. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who sent the book to his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there are no crookedness in the book of the Quran, of Allah. There is no crookedness. There is no contradiction in the book of Allah. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ عِوَجًا سبحان الله. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started Surah Sabah with الحمد. الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. Allah praised himself, the one who owns and everything in the heaven and the earth belong to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ وَهُ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ سبحانه وتعالى. And Allah said also in the beginning of Surah Fatir, verse number 1, Alhamdulillah, Fatir السماوات والأرض, جاعل الملائكة رسلا ولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاثة ورباع. فالله سبحانه وتعالى praised himself, سبحانه وتعالى, the one who is the inventor of the heaven and the earth. سبحان الله. جاعل الملائكة رسل, and he is the one who created the angels. They have wings, مثنى 2, 3, and 4. Jibreel, 600 wings, سبحان الله. فهذه السور started with الحمد, and all الحمد belong to Allah. فلله الحمد رب السماوات ورب الأرض رب العالمين. سورة الجاثية verse number 36. All praises are belong to him, Allah سبحانه وتعالى. If you want to thank, you want to say الحمد, حمد only لله سبحانه وتعالى. سبحانه وتعالى. فهو المحمود عز وجل. له الحمد في الأولى والآخرة. All praises are due to him in the الأولى, in this worldly life also. In the hereafter, in the beginning and in the end, the beginning and also in the end. In Jannah, Jannah رب العالمين, when people will go to their Jannah, inshallah, first word they will say it, Alhamd, and the last word in Jannah they will say it. دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم ها وتحياتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. Yes, we have to know these keys in Jannah, inshallah. They. Whatever you wish, you want, just don't ask anybody, just say Subhanaka Allahumma. Whatever hits your mind there, just say Subhanaka Allahumma. This is the key, you will find it. وَتَحَيَّتُهُمْ فِيهَا سَلَامٌ Their salutation, there is salam. There is no bad talk, if words and these words anymore. Subhanallah, like what Qasim Bhai is saying. There is no bullshit words anymore. This is in the dunya. Qasim Bhai, it's all salam there. Salam, peace, that's it. There is no harm anymore than in Jannah. That's it. They call it vain talks. يعني كلام فعل فاضي. كلام فاضي. ده الكلام ده مش من جنة. وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. فالحمد لله. Allah loves this word. طيب which one is better? To say الشكر لله or الحمد لله. الحمد لله. Yes. In Farsi they say تشكر. شكر يعني. شكر هي. In order. It's الشكر. In Arabic. شكر. To be thankful. Gratitude. Grateful to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. سبحان الله لا الحمد is better because الحمد is started with ألف لام and ألف لام means what الاستغراق يعني تفيد الاستغراق all praises due to Allah كل الحمد all praises but if you will be grateful شاكر فأنت حامد فالشاكر حامد وليس كل حامد شاكر أيوة سبحان الله فالشاكر حامد نعم سوري الحامد شاكر وليس كل شاكر حامد فالحامد تفيد الاستغراق هي كونتينر بيك كونتينر الحمد for everything سبحان الله ابن عباس said الحمد لله كله شاكر yes فالله سبحانه وتعالى said even he gave order to the أنبياء to praise him for example here سيدنا نوح فإذا استويت أنت ومن معك على الفلك when you ride your ark نوح عليه السلام فقل الحمد لله say الحمد لله أيوة say الحمد لله أيوة why because Allah saved you الحمد لله saved you from الظالمين سورة المؤمنون And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in Surah Al-Isra also وقل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا Praise Allah that he did not take a fake God or I'm sorry son for him. Well, Allah doesn't need this. He's free from all of that. And Allah said in Surah An-Naml, قل الحمد لله وسلام على عباد الذين اصطفى. Allah asked the Anbiya, سبحان الله. Sayyidina Ibrahim, الحمد لله الذي وهب لي على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق. He praised Allah, the one who gave him, bestowed on him, Ishmael and Isaac, while he was an old man. Subhanallah. He praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dawood, David and Solomon, طبعاً, they have to be grateful to Allah. Allah gave them prophethood and kingdom. They were muluk and the anbiya. وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ عِلْمًا. We did give Dawood and Solomon, the father and the son, knowledge. وَقَالَ, both, they said. وَقَالَ, أَلْفِ الْإِثْنِينَ. لَا, this أَلْفِ الْإِثْنِينَ for both. وَقَالَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, both of them, they praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِي فَضَّلَنَا عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who made us both superior above too many of the mu'mineen. He gave them the kingdom and the prophethood. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is telling us in the Quran, in the beginning of Surah Ghafir, that الملائكة, they are praising Allah Azza wa Jalla. He said in the Quran here, الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم. سبحان الله. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, تكاد السماوات يتفطرن من فوقهن والملائكة يسبحون بحمد ربهم. Malaika also, some of their tasbih, they are praising Allah. Malaika, the angels. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us also, some of the du'as of the mu'mineen in Jannah, when they will be in Jannah, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَذْهَبَ عَنَّا الْحَزَنِ. When you go to Jannah, you will eat from its fruits. You're going to drink from its water and springs gushing. Kafur, tasneem, zanjabil, mashallah, with too many different flavors in Jannah. You are enjoying there. Subhanallah, the mu'mineen, they will say, وَقَالُوا, they will say, الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. All praise are due to Allah. Why? الَّذِي أَذْهَبَ عَنَّا الْحَزَنِ. He removed all kind of difficulties in our way. الحزن and الحزن, you can say both. الحزن means sadness. الحزن, any difficulties. There is no difficulties anymore. الحزن. So that's why they're going to praise Allah because of that. إِنَّ رَبَّنَا لَغَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Allah is all forgiving. Shakur, he is very appreciative. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shakur. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَهُ. The people of Jannah, they will praise Allah because he did fulfill his promise to us. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. They will praise Allah because Allah, when they're going to be in Jannah, they say, Allah did promise us for that. And we are in Jannah now. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَهُ وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضَ. He let us inherit the earth of Jannah from you. أيوة. قال إن أهل الجنة يلهمون التسبيح والتحميد كما يلهمون نفس. Again, we're going to worship Allah in Jannah. There is no worship Allah in Jannah. خلاص. If you the worship and the عبادة and action is here. There you're going to enjoy. طيب, in Jannah, what are you going to do? You're going to say الحمد لله and you're going to... لا, that's going to be... Allah will inspire you to say تسبيح and الحمد like the way you are breathing. You did not feel it. There is no تكليف in Jannah anymore. تكليف here. Salah here, ibadah here, to do or not here. But there is no takleef. There enjoy, ir'a. That's it. Like just enjoy. Eat and drink, not because you're hungry or thirst. No, just for the joy. That's it. فالحمدللہ رب العالمین. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you hidayah, guidance, and guides your heart, and you do ibadat, and you are in a masjid, you're doing ibadat, subhanallah, you have to praise Allah. And you're gonna remember that when you go to Jannah too. When you will be settled there in Jannah and you sit in your couches, you see your palaces and you're gonna say, it's حلم ولا علم ده يا جماعة. I'm still in dreaming. No dream, it's real. It's real there. When you're gonna go there, you're gonna praise Allah again. Why? What are you gonna say? Quran said in Surah Al-A'raf, verse number 43, the chapter of the heights. What did Allah say? Alhamdulillah, the people of Jannah will say, Alhamdulillah الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. Means they, when you go, see, that's, you're gonna say this when you will be in Jannah to remember this dunya, and you will praise Allah, the one who guided you to pray Salat al-Fajr in the Masjid now. Why? Because this Salat al-Fajr will lead you to that Jannah. So that's why Alhamdulillah, Allah guided me to do all of these good deeds to bring me here. Because of these good deeds, I'm here. فالحمدلله هدانا. He's the one who guided us to do good to come to the Jannah. Otherwise, we will not be in Jannah. فالملائكة they will stand outside the doors of Jannah. What they're gonna say? They're gonna say سبحان الله welcome, they're gonna welcome the مؤمنين and they will say تلكم الجنة أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون. This is the Jannah you will inherit it because of what you used to do. Nothing free. أنت you are the one who is building his Jannah from now. Believe me. Your salah in the masjid, your salah in jama'ah, your good deeds you are doing now. Now you are, you did not know that, but you are actually in reality building up your Jannah while you are here. سبحان الله. بقول لك فيه in bad way in dunya because we are so bad as a human being. في حاجة اسمها الحرب بالوكالة. الحرب بالإيه؟ بالوكالة. I will give example between me and the brother عبد المجيد. I want to hurt brother عبد المجيد. I'm sorry شيخ, I'm just giving an example. I will hire somebody to bother him, to say something bad in the internet about him. And I will give him money to do that. Like someone used to do that with me for 6 years. I have like 10 websites against me in the internet. I'm very famous, you don't know. SubhanAllah, see? Somebody's giving money to somebody stupid, both, to hurt some, say Jum'ah, or to say something about so-and-so from people, right? Yani even that Sheikh Abdullah Kamil, the one who just died last week here in New York, now in the social media in Egypt, they talk about bad about him. The man died, خلاص, leave him alone with Allah. Now they are trying to put him down. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. أي والله ما بقول لك إحنا فيه ناس شياطين بيسموها الحرب بالوكالة. يعني إيه الحرب بالوكالة؟ They want to bring Egypt to fight with Sudan. They bring somebody شيطان in the middle. بيسموها الحرب بالوكالة. أوكي؟ لا إن جنة بقى في حاجة اسمها بالوكالة برضو. إيش الوكالة دي؟ There is somebody working for you. الملائكة they are building up your Jannah because of your good deeds here. You are paying for that now. What kind of this is your currency? What your good deeds? The good deeds is, they are working from now. الملائكة they are working. Rasulullah was in Mi'raj. He saw some angels they are planting trees in Jannah. When he came back, they stopped. They were standing, not sitting, just not working. And he asked Jibreel alayhi salam, this malaika, they were planting trees here. I said, because Rasulullah, he said, Jannah, sallallahu alayhi salam. Why they stopped? He said, this is for somebody who used to make tasbih and zikr. He stopped, they stopped. That's it, you know. That's why he said, Ghiras al-Jannah, the advice of Prophet Ibrahim to you, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, wa akbar. Huh? You make this zikr, this azkar, that's Ghiras al-Jannah. They are planting for you trees. They are extending your Jannah there. That's why you have to know that you are the one who is making بتغزل جنتك وانت في الأرض. انت اللي بتعملها. Nobody's doing anything for you. Allah سبحانه وتعالى appointed الملائكة to work for you there. You work here, they are working there. This exactly the way. فده مؤمنين will say الحمد لله. Allah guides us during our worldly life to do salah, zikr, عبادة, Quran. سبحان الله. All of these عبادات, that's why we are here. Otherwise, we will never be guided. We will never gonna come here. Alhamdulillah, الذي هدانا لهذا to do good for this time. وما كنا نهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. سبحان الله. Also, there is a hadith لا أحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. فالله سبحانه وتعالى he loves this ثناء. There are too many hadith. For example, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في صحيح البخاري عند مسلم حديث أنس he was visiting that little boy who was Jewish little boy in his sickness who was about to die and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he asked him say la ilaha illallah and the boy his uncle and his dad they were standing beside him and he scared from his dad he looked like this Rasul saying him say la ilaha illallah because he was dying and the little boy he's Jewish was looking at his dad like this scared And his dad told him, أطع أبا القاسم, obey أبا القاسم. Jewish. He said, obey أبا القاسم. In this situation, he cannot lie to his son. He cannot lie to himself. He said, أطع أبا القاسم, obey أبا القاسم. And the boy said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. And he died. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was so happy. And he said, الحمد لله الذي أنقذه الله بي من النار. He praised Allah that Allah saved him from the hellfire. فرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he praised Allah for that سبحان الله also let me ask you brother Sharif what is إلياء القدس إلياء القدس this is the Torah شيخ In the name of Al-Quds, yes, Ilya, I think. Rasul said, let me say the hadith. I wouldn't give you, but I think, yes, yes, Al-Quds. Yes, one of the names of Al-Quds, Ilya. That's right. I remember now. Yeah. So what happened, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he was in Isra al-Mi'raj, his two journeys, Sayyidina Jibreel, he met him there. عندما أسري به به بإيلياء بإيلياء means طبعا بالقدس صلى الله عليه وسلم. Well, he was a leader of the Imam of the Anbiya. بإيلياء أوتي بقدحين. Jibreel gave him two cups. One خمر alcohol, another one milk. And they said, choose يا محمد. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he chooses the milk. And Jibreel عليه السلام, Jibreel said, الحمد لله. Jibreel himself said, Alhamdulillah, you choose the fitra, ya Muhammad. If you choose al-khamr, your ummah will be misguided. Subhanallah. But you choose the fitra, al-laban, the milk. Subhanallah. The point of the hadith, Jibreel, he said, Alhamdulillah. He was so happy. When you become happy or Allah gives you something good, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Praise Allah. But anyway, the Muslim also must say Alhamdulillah in both conditions. If you get something good or bad, whatever, say Alhamdulillah. Yes. Anyway, say Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. There are too many hadiths stealing them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described also the mu'mineen, some of the good characteristics of the mu'mineen in Surah At-Tawbah, verse 112. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. سبحان الله. الآيات إلى until he said the beige from the top. التائبون, some of the characteristics of the مؤمنين. التائبون, those who are repenting. العابدون, those who are worshipping Allah. الحامدون, those who are praising Allah. السائحون, those who are thinking about Allah's greatness. السائح, السائح من السياحة يعني traveling. الراكعون, الراكعون those who are bound making ركوع. الساجدون, those who are making سجود. الآمرون بالمعروف والنهون عن المنكر, those who are joining people for معروف forbidding them from المنكر. والحافظون لحدود الله, those who are guarding the limits of Allah, they never go beyond of Allah, they never make any كبائر major sin. Allah said وبشر المؤمنين, give glad tidings to the مؤمنين. If you have these characteristics, glad tidings على طول. فالحامدون الذين حمدوا الله على أحايينهم كلها. الحسن said that in any condition they say الحمد لله good or bad. سبحان الله. ف don't be like that man I was explaining سورة الفجر last night. فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه فيقول ربي أكرمان, وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهنان. Don't be like these people. If Allah gives you Allah honored me, if Allah take from you deprived you, why Allah is humiliating me? Don't think like this. If Allah gives you, this is not a sign of love. If He deprived you, this is not a sign of, you know. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you, يعني, during السراء والضراء, the ease and hardship, praise Allah. This is what Imam Sa'd said in his tafsir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in Surah Al-Fatiha, we read it 17 times every day. He said, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي خِسْمَيْنِ. I make the salah half for you and for Allah. Allah said, I make it half and half. The hadith said, وَالْعَبْدِ مَسَأَلْ فَإِذَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ سورة الفاتحة, Allah will answer and Allah will say, حَمَدَنِي عَبْدِي, my servants praised me. سبحان الله, there are too many كنوز وفضائل الدعاء. When you say الحمد لله رب العالمين, أفضل الدعاء الحمد, the best دعاء سورة الحمد, الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأفضل عباد الله يوم القيامة الحمادون, صحيح الألباني, that's authentic hadith عن عمران بن حسين, those who will be superior in the day of judgment, those who are praising Allah, الحمادون. الحماد, the one who saying الحمد لله, الحمد لله, you're gonna be in high status there. أحب الكلام إلى الله, the most beloved four words to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, سبحان الله, الحمد لله, لا إله إلا الله, الله أكبر. لا يضرك بأيهن بدأت, start with any one of them, don't worry. رسول الله said that, that's صحيح. فالحمد لله يا جماعة بكل تسبيحة صدقة. When we say make سبحان الله, it's a صدقة. When we say الله أكبر, صدقة. When we say الحمد لله, it's صدقة. وكل تهليلة, what's تهليل means? تهليل means say لا إله إلا الله, صدقة. All of these سبحان الله, when you remember Allah, الملائكة they will surround you. When you say الحمد لله and you make ذكر, الملائكة they will be around you, سبحان الله. فالله سبحانه وتعالى will love you and Allah will wipe out your sin, even if your sin like the foam of the ocean, according to the hadith. I will finish with this dua or this hadith. Actually, hadith. Hadith said, رواه الإمام أحمد وصححه الألباني عن عبد الله بن عمر أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال بخن 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 بخن. The word بخن بخن يعني in Arabic language when you say something good, very good, say بخن بخن. Wow, they say wow nowadays. See something, you're surprised, you wow. No, it's not wow in Arabic. بخن 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 means what a good thing. خمس ما أثقلهن في الميزان. Five things that they are very heavy in the scale of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. سبحان الله very heavy in the scale of Allah. حسنات. الحمد لله heavy حسنات. Allah said, رسول الله said in the hadith, والحمد لله تملأ الميزان. الميزان it's bigger than the heaven and the earth. And when you say الحمد لله, الميزان will be full of حسنات for you. والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. When you say this, ميزان is full. والولد الصالح يتوفى فيحتسبه والده. If somebody has a boy, a pious son, and if he die, and his son, his father said, إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون, and he is محتسب that, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said that will, يعني سبحان الله, will make your ميزان very heavy. جماعة الحمد لله, we'll start the salawat, and in the, we end the hour salawat with الحمد لله. الركوع, we stand from الركوع, سمع الله لمن حامدة. سبحان الله is listening to you. عند النوم, when we sleep, say الحمد لله. سبحان الله. Who said that? رسول الله was advising علي بن أبي طالب and فاطمة when they ask for a servant. He said, يا علي يا فاطمة, don't ask for a servant. When you sleep, say سبحان الله 33 times. الحمد لله 33 times. الله أكبر 34 times. 34 times. 34. It's better than خادم, servant for you. طيب. When you wake up during the night while you're sleeping, when you say الحمد لله also, سبحان الله, Allah, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى will forgive your sin if you mention the name of Allah. When you wake up, الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعد ما أمتنا وإليه النشور. Also there is a reward for that. سبحان الله. See, in the morning, in the evening, say الحمد لله, praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى. When you finish your food, you say الحمد لله, right? When you finish, when you drink, or you eat, الحمد لله, when you finish. All of these 20 hadith, but just something. الحمد لله الذي أطعامنا وسقانا وجعلنا مسلمين. When you eat your food, سبحان الله. All of these, الحمد, is very important. When you sneeze, that's, huh? Say what? الحمد لله. What about if somebody did not say الحمد لله? Are you going to tell him, يرحمك الله?
No.
Don't tell him, يرحمك الله. Yes. Tell him, if somebody sneezes, but he did not say الحمد لله. Don't tell him يرحمك الله until he say الحمد لله. And teach him. That's right. Yes. What about if he said it twice? If he sneezed it twice and he said الحمد لله, tell him يرحمك الله. What about third time? Huh? He sneezed third time and they said الحمد لله. Are you gonna tell him يرحمك الله? أيوة, thank you. He's sick. He must go to the doctor. Tell him شفاك الله. All the night, all the day. He's sick. Tell him شفاك الله. The third time. Yes, this is the way. Time. عند اللباس, when you wear something new, من لبس ثوبا فقال الحمد لله الذي كساني هذا الثوب ورزقني من غير حول لا ولا قوة ولي ولا قوة غفر الله غفر الله له. When you wear new clothes, you praise الحمد, you say الحمد لله, Allah will forgive you. سبحان الله. And all of this, عند ركوب الدابة, when you ride your car, what you have to say, did you, بسم الله three times, بسم الله, بسم الله, سبحان الذي سخر, الحمد لله, first, and say, سبحان الذي سخر لنا هذا وما كنا له مقرنين, وإنا إلى ربنا لمنقلبون. ده دعاء ركوب الدابة, when you ride your donkey. All of this, عند رؤية المبتلى, if you see somebody sick or somebody مبتلى, he has ابتلاء, sick or poverty or أيوة. الحمد لله الذي عافانا مما ابتلى به غيرنا وفضلنا على كثير من خلق تفضيلا. Praise Allah, the one who gave you. But this see somebody sick, somebody كذا, I say الحمد لله, I'm still healthy. الحمد لله, I have a house. الحمد لله, I have kids. الحمد لله, I have this. Praise Allah for that. When you see somebody مبتلى, being examined. في السراء والضراء, during the east time and difficult time. عند حلول النعم, if Allah give you something good, الحمد لله. سبحان الله. All of this. في ختام المجلس, when you have مجلس like this, and we are sitting together, we talk about everybody in the city. I mentioned the name of Allah before we leave, and say Alhamdulillah because this is kafarat al-majlis. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك إلا غفر الله ما كان له في مجلسه. This كفارة المجلس. You backbite somebody, you talk about someone. When you say this دعاء سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Allah will forgive you. I'm asking الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلني وإياكم من الحمادين. آمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من الحمدين الذين يحمدونك في السراء والضراء يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافينا واسترنا واجبرنا واهدنا يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير. Sorry for...